Hello everyone, welcome to second part of fourth lecture. So now start with first example in which we will calculate the cracking moment and induced stresses. The question is, a reinforced concrete beam of size 350 mm into 600 mm is made up of M20 grade of concrete and reinforced with 4 bar of 20 mm dia of Fe415 steel. The question is, calculate the cracking moment of beam and stresses due to an applied moment of 55 kN. Take the value M for modular ratio for M20 grade of concrete at 13.33 and assume effective power of 50 mm. Most of the time the value of modular ratio will be given in your question. If it is not given, you have to find out it from IS code. So now let's take a look on strategy to solve this problem. First is, find out the modulus of rupture. Then use the cracking moment formula, either considering the gross area or by transforming the steel into equivalent concrete area. And the third is, the stresses can be find out after determining the phase which is the crack phase, uncrack phase or elastic phase. So the solution is, first note down the value which are given in question. The overall depth of concrete beam section D is 600 mm. And the breadth of this beam section is 350 mm. The reinforced steel, there are 4 bar of 20 mm dia. And the effective cover is 50 mm. This is the cover we use to protect the steel from corrosion and different types of effect. Here, the grade of concrete is M20, so the characteristic strength will be 20 MPa, or we can say it Newton per mm square. And we have Fe415 steel, and that's why the yield strength of steel will be Fy is equal to 415 MPa and modular ratio is 13.33. So the first step for this question is, find the value of modulus of rupture FCR, and we know the formula of FCR. It is FCR is equal to 0.7 under root FCK. So we know that the value of FCK is 20 MPa. So the formula will be 0.7 under root 20, and this value will be 3.13 Newton per mm square. So the second step is, find the cracking moment using the gross area. Here the formula for cracking moment is MCR is equal to FCR into I over Y. Here I is the moment of inertia for gross area and Y is the distance of extreme tension fiber from neutral axis. So we know that the moment of inertia will be BD cube upon 12 and the Y, distance of extreme tension fiber from neutral axis, will be D/2. So it will be FCR into BD square upon 6. Now put all the values. Here we have already calculated the value of FCR. It will be 3.13. The breadth of section will be 350 mm. And the overall depth is 600 square upon 6. So it will be 3.13 into 21 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm. We can convert it into kilonewton meter. So it will be 65.73 kilonewton meter. So here we have find out the value of cracking moment using the gross area. So the third step is, find the cracking moment using the transform area method. The formula will be MCR is equal to FCR into IT upon YT. Here IT is the moment of inertia of transform area and YT is the distance of extreme tension fiber from neutral axis for transform area. So here we can find out the value of cracking moment FCR using the transform area method, but first we have to find out some more data. The area of tension steel is AST because we have 4 bar of 20 mm dia, so it will be 4 into pi 4 into 20 square and the value is 1256.64 mm square. Next, we have to find out the area of transform section. So it is AT, It will be the concrete area plus transform area of steel. We can write it down as AG is the gross area of overall beam section minus AST. Here the AST is the area of steel that is replaced from concrete section plus MAST. This MAST is the transform area of steel which is equivalent in the form of concrete. So we can write it down as AG plus M minus 1 AST. So let me illustrate you, we replaced all the steel with equivalent concrete area and this is the M minus 1 AST. So the gross area is B into D plus M minus 1 AST. Now let's put all the value. The value of B is 350 and the overall depth is 600 plus modular ratio 13.33 minus 1 into area of steel 1256.64. So here we found the overall area of transform section as 225.5 into 10 to power 3 mm square. Now the next point is depth of neutral lattice of transform area. So we can calculate it by taking moment of transform area above the top edge. Here AD into Y is equal to BD into DY2 plus M minus 1 AST into the distance of this area from extreme tension fiber, it is small d. We called it effective depth. So now put the value of AT is 225.5 into 10 to power 3 into Y is equal to the value of B 350 and the D is 600 into DY2 is 600 upon 2 plus modular ratio 13.33 minus 1 into area of steel 1256.64 into effective depth. It will be 600 minus effective power 50 will be equal to 550 mm. So the final value of neutral axis will be Y equal to 317.17 mm. It will be equal to the neutral axis distance from extreme compression fiber. That's why we call it YC. It will be equal to 317.17 mm. The distance of steel from neutral axis will be 550 minus 317.17 and it will be equal to 232.83 mm. Another important is the YT. It is the distance of extreme tension fiber from neutral axis. It will be 600 minus 317.17 and it will be equal to 282.83 mm. And we represent it with YT. So here we have find out all the necessary data. Now let's find out the moment of inertia of transform area section IT. IT will be equal to the moment of inertia of upper section, it is BYC cube upon 3 plus the moment of inertia, the section which is below the neutral axis, it will be BYT cube upon 12 and moment of inertia of transform area section, which is M minus 1 AST into the distance of this area from neutral axis YS square. Now put all the value in this formula. Here the value of B is 350 into 317.17 cube upon 3 plus 350 into 282.83 cube upon 3 plus modular ratio 13.33 minus 1 into area of steel 1256.64 into the YS value 232.83 square. After solving further, we find out that the value is 3722.4 into 10 to power 6 plus 2639.5 into 10 to power 6 plus 840 into 10 to power 6. The final value will be 7201.9 into 10 to power 6 mm power 4. So here we have find out all the necessary data to find out the cracking moment. The value of modulus of rupture FCR is equal to 3.13 Newton per mm square. The moment of inertia for transform area IT is equal to 7201.9 × 10⁶ mm^4, and the value of extreme tension fiber from mutual axis YT is equal to 282.83 mm. So now put all these value into cracking moment formula. Here 3.13 × 7201.9 × 10⁶ upon 282.83. So the final value is 79.7 × 10⁶ newton mm, and we can transform it into 79.7 kilo newton meter. So here we have find out two value of cracking moment. It is 65.73 kilo newton meter using gross area method, and now the 79.7 kilo newton meter using transform area method. So you can see here that transform area method give more precise and accurate result as compared to gross area method. So here we have finished the first part of this question, the cracking moment. So the second part is that find out the stresses due to an applied moment of 55 kilo newton meter. So the fourth step is our find the value of stresses due to an applied moment of 55 kilo newton meter. So here the value of applied moment is 55 kilo newton meter, which is less than the cracking moment. It means section is uncracked. So we can see here that the complete area of concrete is effective to resist the compressive as well as tensile stresses. First we have to find out the maximum compressive stresses in concrete. Here we can use formula Fc is equal to M upon IT into YC. The value of M, applied moment, is 55 × 10⁶ upon value of moment of inertia of transform area is 7201.9 × 10⁶ into the distance of compression fiber from neutral axis is 317.17. And the final value of compressive stresses is 2.42 newton per mm square. Next is maximum tensile stresses in concrete. Here we can calculate it using the similar formula, Ft is equal to M upon IT into YT. But there is another way to find this value. If you look at the stress profile, here we can use the similar triangle formula, Fc into Yt upon Yc, and here we know the value of Fc 2.42 × 282.83 upon 317.17. Hence the value of tensile stresses is 2.16 newton per mm square. So here we have find out the value of compressive stresses and tensile stresses in concrete. Now the maximum tensile stresses in steel. If you look at the stress profile again, here we can reduce the strength of steel using modular ratio. It will be Fst upon M to make it equivalent to concrete strength. So the value of Fst will be M into Fc into Ys upon Yc, and we know all the values to put in this formula. 13.33 is the value of modular ratio into 2.42 the compressive stress into 232.83 the value of Ys upon 317.17. So the final value of tensile stresses in steel is 23.68 newton per mm square. So here we have finished the first example, and I hope you have understood the concept of cracking moment and stresses is more clearly here. So now move to the second example. So in second example, we will find out the moment of resistance and area of steel for balance section. The question is, a reinforced concrete beam of size 400 × 650 mm is made up of M30 grade of concrete and reinforced with, in first case is 3 bar of 16 mm dia, and in second case is 6 bar of 25 mm dia, and both of them are steel of Fe415. So in this question, we have to calculate the moment of resistance of beam and area of steel required for balance section. The value of modular ratio is given for M30 grade of concrete as 9, and you can assume here the effective cover of 50 mm. So the strategy for this question is, for first part, the moment of resistance, first you have to find the critical and actual depth of neutral axis. Then on comparison of both values, find the section type. It is either under reinforced section, over reinforced section, or balanced section. Then find the compressive and tensile stresses according to section type. And after that, you have find out the stresses, find the moment of resistance from compression as well as tension side, as I have described you earlier in this lecture. For the second part of this lecture, for the area of steel for balanced section, there are three methods to find out this area of steel. First, find the moment of resistance from compression side formula and put the value of moment of resistance in tension side formula, and here you can find out the value of steel. Second method is using equation of equilibrium, find the compression force and tension force and put them equal to each other, and you can find out the value of steel. And the third method is equating the moment of area on both sides. So start the solution of this question with first case, where we have 3 bar of 16 mm dia. So first write down the value which is given in this question. The overall depth of beam section is 650 mm. The breadth of beam is 400 mm. The reinforced steel, there are 3 bar of 16 mm dia, and we know that the effective cover is 50 mm, and the effective depth will be 650 minus 50, and it will be 600 mm. We have given the grade of concrete is M30, that's why the characteristic strength as such will be 30 Newton per mm square, and steel is Fe415, and the value of Fy will be 415 Newton per mm square. The value of modular ratio is given for M30 grade of concrete as 9. Next, we have to find out the permissible stresses, which is already given in IS code. In most of the competitive examination, the value of permissible stress is already given in question. But it may happen that the value of permissible stresses is not given, then you have to find out from IS code. Here you can see here that for M30 grade of concrete, the value of sigma CBC is 10. And for steel, if you look here that we have the 16 mm bar dia, which is less than 20 mm. Hence, the value of sigma SP will be 230 Newton per mm square. Hence, the value of sigma CBC 10 Newton per mm square, and the value of sigma ST is 230 Newton per mm square. So we have all the data that we use in this question. So here we can find out one more thing is area of steel. We know that we have 3 bar of 16 mm dia, so it will be 3 into pi by 4 into 16 square, and the area is 603.2 mm square. So the first step here in this question, find the depth of critical neutral axis. And I have explained you earlier in this lecture that the depth of critical neutral axis we can find out with S is equal to Kd, where value of K is 1 upon 1 plus sigma ST upon M sigma CBC. So we can use the formula here, XC is equal to Kd, where the value of Kd is 1 upon 1 plus sigma ST upon M sigma CBC into D. And we have all the values here. So put all the value in this formula. This will be 1 upon 1 plus 230 upon 9 into 600. Hence the final value is 168.75 mm. This is the value of critical neutral axis. Now move to the second step. Find the depth of actual neutral axis. It is axis. If you remember, I have explained you earlier that we can find out the depth of actual neutral axis with the taking the moment about neutral axis. Here the formula is B into XA square is equal to M into AST into D minus XA. Here we can put all the value is B is 400 into XA square upon 2 is equal to the value of modular ratio is 9 into area 50 is 603.2 into 600 minus XA. Further we can write this equation as 200 into XA square into 3257280 minus 5428.8 XA. Here we can find out the value of XA using the scientific calculator. XA is equal to 114.76 mm. You can see here that the value of actual neutral axis is less than critical neutral axis, 168.75 mm. So in the third step, find the actual compressive stresses in concrete, because actual depth of neutral axis is less than the critical depth of neutral axis, hence the section is under reinforced section. It simply means that actual stresses in concrete section does not reach to the level of permissible stresses in concrete. But in steel, the actual stresses reach to the level of permissible stresses, and we have known that the value of permissible stresses here is 230 Newton per mm square. So if you look at the stress profile for under reinforced section, here we can use with similar triangle that sigma dash CBC upon XA is equal to sigma ST upon M upon D minus XA. So here we can write down the sigma dash CBC is equal to sigma ST upon M upon D minus XA into XA. Now put all the value. The value of sigma ST is 230 upon modular ratio 9 upon 600 minus 114.76 into 114.76, and the final value of compressive stresses, the actual compressive stress is 6.04 Newton per mm square. So the next step is calculate the moment of resistance, and we can find out the moment of resistance from two sides. First start from compression side, and we know that moment of resistance is compression force into lever arm. It will be 1 upon 2 sigma dash CBC into area, that is B into XA into lever arm B minus XA upon 3. And we know all the value. The value of sigma dash CBC we have find out is 6.04 into breadth of beam 400 into actual neutral axis depth 114.76 into the value of effective depth 600 minus 114.76 upon 3. Hence the final value of moment of resistance is 77.87 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm, and we can convert it into 77.87 kilonewton meter. And we can also calculate the moment of resistance from tension side, and it will be the tension force into the lever arm. And we know that the tension force will be sigma ST into AST into the lever arm will be D minus XA upon 3. So now put the value of sigma ST 230 Newton per mm square. It is the permissible stress, and area of steel is 603.2 mm square into the effective depth 600 minus 114.76 upon 3. And from this you can see here that the value is similar to compression side, 77.9 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm, and we can also convert it into 77.9 kilonewton meter. So here now move to the second case where we have the 6 bar of 25 mm dia. So in second case all the given data is similar as the previous one, but here we have 6 bar of 25 mm dia. So area of steel will be 6 into pi by 4 into 25 square, and it is 2945.24 mm square. So let's start here with first step. Find out the depth of critical neutral axis XC, and it will be similar 168.75 mm square. as we have calculated it in first case, because the depth of critical axis does not depend on area of steel. Okay. Now the second step, find the depth of actual neutral axis xa, and here we use the similar equation, b into xa square upon 2 is equal to m into ast into d minus xa. Here the value of b is 400 into xa square upon 2, the modular ratio is 9 and the area of steel is 2945.24 into 600 minus xa. So here you can solve this equation and the value of xa is 223.41 mm, which is greater than 168.75 mm, the depth of critical neutral axis. So here we can say that this section is over reinforced. So the third step is find the actual tensile stresses in steel. Why? Because xa is greater than xc. So the section is over reinforced, and we know that in case of over reinforced section, the stresses in concrete reach to the level of permissible stresses and the value of sigma cbc will be 10 newton per mm square, but actual stresses in steel sigma dash st are less than permissible stresses sigma st. So if you look at the stress profile for over reinforced section, here we can use the similar triangle property. So the sigma cbc upon xa will be equal to sigma dash st upon m upon d minus xa. So here we can solve this equation for sigma dash st. It will be equal to d minus xa into sigma cbc into m upon xa, and we can put all the value here. The value of d is 600 minus 223.41 into value of sigma cbc is 10 into modular ratio 9 upon the actual depth, that is 223.41, and here we can find out the final value of stresses in steel is 151.7 newton per mm square. So we have calculated all the stresses. Now move to the fourth step, calculate moment of resistance. So first start from compression side. We know that moment of resistance is compression force into lever arm, and it will be equal to 1 upon 2 sigma cbc into area b into xa into lever arm d minus x upon 3, and the value is 1 by 2 10 into 400 into actual neutral axis depth 223.41 into 600 minus 223.41 upon 3. Then this value will be 234.8 into 10 to the power 6 newton mm, and we can convert it into the higher form, 234.8 kilo newton meter. Now calculate the moment of resistance from tension side. Tension force into lever arm, and it will be equal to sigma dash st into ast into d minus xa upon 3. And we know that we use here sigma dash st because stresses in tension does not reach to the level of permissible stresses. So now put all the value here. The value of sigma dash st is 151.7 into area of steel 2945.24 into 600 minus 223.41 upon 3, and here the final value is 234.84 into 10 to the power 6 newton mm, and we can convert it into higher form, 234.84 kilo newton meter. And you can see here that the value of moment of resistance from compression side and tension side are equal. So here we have finished the two cases of moment of resistance. So now the next part of the question is find the area of steel required for balance section. And I have told you earlier in this lecture that there are three methods to find out the area of steel. So let's start with one by one. The first method is find the moment of resistance from compression side formula and put the value of moment of resistance in tension side formula. And we know that for balance section the actual depth and critical depth is equal, then it will be 168.75 mm, and the value of sigma CBC will be 10 Newton per mm square, and value of sigma ST will be 230 Newton per mm square. Now put all these value in the moment of resistance formula from compression side. It will be compression force into lever arm equal to 1 by 2 sigma CBC into B into XA into D minus XA upon 3. Put all the value here, 1 by 2 into 10 into 400 into 168.75 into effective depth 600 minus 168.75 upon 3. So the value of moment of resistance is 183.52 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm. Now the formula of moment of resistance from tension side will be tension force into lever arm. It will be equal to sigma ST into AST into D minus XA upon 3. Now put all the value here. Moment of resistance is 183.52 into 10 to the power 6 is equal to sigma ST 230 Newton per mm square, area of steel, it will be AST, we have to find out it here, into 600 minus 168.76 upon 3. So you can solve this equation and find out the value of area of steel, and it will be 1467.47 mm square. The second method I have told you is using the equation of equilibrium. So here we can equate the compression force is equal to tension force, and we already know the formula for compression force. It is 1 by 2 sigma CBC into B into XA is equal to sigma ST into AST. So the value of sigma CBC is 10, for B is 400, and the value of neutral axis is 168.75, and we know that the permissible stress for tension is 230 Newton per mm square, and area of steel will be, so you can find out here the area of steel, it is 1467.47 mm square, which is similar to the first method. And the third method is equating the moment of area on both sides of neutral axis. You can see here, this is the cross section view, and the moment of area about the neutral axis is B into XA into XAY is equal to M into AST into D minus XA. You can further modify this formula to find out the value of area of steel. AST is equal to B into XA square upon 2M D minus XA. Now put all the value here. Value of B is 400 into neutral axis 168.75 square upon 2 into 9 into 600 minus 168.75. The final value is 1467.39 mm square. So you can see here that I have used three methods, and all of them give the equal value of area of steel. So here we have finished the fourth lecture. Now let's summarize this lecture. Initially, in the first part, I explained you the assumption of working stress method. Secondly, the depth of neutral axis, in which I explained you the actual and critical depth. Then we learned about the different types of section, like balanced section, under reinforced section, over reinforced section. And finally, in the first part, I explain you the concept of moment of resistance. In second part, I explain you two practical examples. So if you have any doubt, please comment here. Stay tuned. We will release next lecture soon. Thanks for watching.